The fact that there are so many century farms and that more come into the program every day is astonishing to most Tennesseans. About 600 farms across the state came into the program in the 1970s and were duly recognized in 1976. The program then continued on, and when the Center for Historic Preservation was established in 1984, the Tennessee Department of Agriculture, realizing what a tremendous collection of photographs and agricultural history they had in these applications, they asked the center to take over its administration, and so we have been at that for about 25 years now. So we decided that because there are so many wonderful stories on every century farm with every generation, that we would begin a series of videos, maybe trying to do two or three of them a year. Our first video is about the McDonald Craig Century Farm in Perry County. It is one of those rare century farms that was established by African Americans as they became emancipated in the 1870s. The story is a wonderful story about how they purchased this farm, this married couple, both ex-slaves, their children were ex-slaves, and it has remained in the family since that time. Also, McDonald Craig, the current owner, is a well-known folk musician, and he also participated very quietly in the civil rights movement by driving a bus from Perry County to Henderson County for 10 years, carrying black students who wanted to attend high school.
I would like to tell you about Lizzie and Will. They are my old grandparents. They laugh, give me a thrill. They raised just 12 kids, 3 girls and 9 boys. And all the things that they taught them have brought me lots of joy.
Our friend Pat Jackson, Assistant Director of AV Services, was in charge of producing the DVD. A self-described recovery musician, he said it was particularly enjoyable to work with McDonald Craig.
It's really cool. Kenita Hankins, an old friend of ours, called me on this project. Gosh, it's probably been 5 years ago. She and I were talking about that and told me about McDonald Craig over in Perry County, that he was an African-American gentleman who played in the style of Jimmy Rogers, but also his family had owned this farm for over 100 years. So one Saturday morning, I was living out in Cannon County at the time, and I got up bright and early and drove to Perry County. It's a long way from Cannon County to Perry County, by the way. But I went over there and to meet Mac and to videotape his performance and do an interview with him. Interesting, we got there early, and Mac was supposed to, they had a flatbed truck set up, and Mac was supposed to perform on that stage at around 10 o'clock, I think. So Kenita and I were sitting around at the flatbed truck, and 10 o'clock came and went, no Mac. So we started searching for him, and finally someone said, well, he's set up under a tree down by all of the arts and crafts people. And sure enough, we went down there, and there was Mac set up under a tree with his little makeshift PA system and playing his tunes. And it was I loved it immediately. I loved that old style of music.